أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمد عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين وبعد. Tonight, the night of the 12th of the month of Muharram, from the Ashhur al-Hurum, from the four sacred month of Islam, of the four sacred month of Islam, from the three consecutive ones, Ayyi, Dhul Qa'da, Dhul Hijjah, Muharram, and that which is between Jumada and Sha'ban, which is the month of Ar-Rajab, or the month of Rajab. So tonight, alhamdulillah, we are here again by the permission of Allah and from the bounties of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to sit together and to be reading the books of the ulama, ulama'u ahlu sunnati wal jama'a, qadiman wa hadithan, and reading something that is in regard to our aqidah, which is the most important aspect of the religion. Imam Ahmad rahimahullah, he say, وَأَنَّ عِيسَ بْنَ مَرْيَمَ يَنْزِلُ فَيَقْتُلُهُ بِبَابِ لُدِّن أو بِنَعَمْ بِبَابِ لُدِّن. That believing also that Isa alayhi salatu wasalam, the son of Mary, or the son of Maryam, يَنْزِلُ, he will descend, فَيَقْتُلُهُ, and he will kill him, meaning the Dajjal, the Antichrist, بِبَابِ لُدِّن, at a place that is called Babulud. And we mentioned, barakallah fikum, in reading the statement of Sheikh Rabi Hafidhahullah, when he say that this, هذا وارد في الأحاديث الصحيح وهو في صحيح مسلم. He say here this point of aqidah, it is being taken from the authentic narrations, from them the narration of Imam Muslim rahimahullah, annahu yanzilu Isa, stating the fact that Isa alayhi salatu wasalam will descend. And how he will descend? As the hadith mentioned, that he will descend on holding on the wings of two angels. And then he will be descending, barakallahu fikum, between the minarets, and more precisely in the eastern minaret of Damascus, in the eastern minaret of Damascus. And he will be dressed with two garments that will be dyed in saffron. So therefore, فيسلط هذا المسيح النبي الرسول على المسيح الدجال, that this Messiah will defeat, meaning this Messiah who is a prophet and a messenger, will defeat this Antichrist who is a Dajjal. وتسمية عيسى ابن مريم مسيح بالمسيح من سياحتي أو من السياحة. He say that naming the name of Isa عليه الصلاة والسلام in regard to the term Al-Masih applicable to Isa, it is because of his traveling and giving da'wah throughout the earth. وَتَسْمِيَةُ الدَّجَّال, and the naming of الدَّجَّال Al-Masih, it is because of لِأَنَّ عَيْنُهُ مَمْسُوحَ, that because of his right eye is blind. It's like a floating grape. So because of his right eye is like a floating grape. وَعِيسَى عَلَيْهِ السَّلَاةُ وَالسَّلَامُ نَبِي رَسُولُ وَذَاكَ كَاذِبٌ دَجَّالٌ, and the latter one, meaning the Masih al-Dajjal, He is a liar. And he is, yani, in... Yes, he is an imposter and a liar. So he mentioned, هَذَا الْمَسِيحُ الدَّجَّالِ هَذَا الْمَسِيحُ الدَّجَّالِ وَهَذَا الْمَسِيحُ عِيسَى بْنَ مَرْيَمْ عَلَيْهِ السَّلَاةُ وَالسَّلَامُ فَيُهْلِكُهُ اللَّهُ عَلَى يَدِهِ. He say, here is Masih al-Dajjal, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will destroy him on the hands of Isa alayhi salatu wasalam. And this was when we took a side note and we were reading, barakallahu fikum, the statement of Sheikh Saleh al-Fawzan hafidhahullah in his explanation of Sharh al-Sunnah li-Imam al-Barbahari rahimahullah. As Imam al-Barbahari, he stated, wal-Iman bi-Nuzuli Isa ibn Maryama, believing in the descending of Isa, the son of Maryam. Yanzilu, he will descend. Fayaqtulu ad-Dajjal, and he will kill the Dajjal. Alaykum as-salam. ويتزوج, and he will get married. طيب, ويتزوج, he will get married. ويصلي خلف القائم من آل محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. And we mentioned about the term he'll get married to make a circle on it. ويصلي, and he will pray خلف القائم min ali Muhammad, and he will pray behind someone from the descendants of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Wa yamutu, and he will die. Wa yadfinuhu al muslimun, and the believers, meaning the Muslim, they will do what? They will bury him. Sheikh Fawzan hafidhahullah, as we stated, he mentioned that the descending of Isa alayhi salatu wasalam, it is from the alamatul kubra of as-sa'a, from the alamatul sa'a al-kubra, from the major sign of the hour, the descending of Isa, it is from the major sign of the hour. The descending of Isa, it is from the major sign of the hour. So he talked about also nuzuluhu, the descending of Isa alayhi salatu wasalam, bima'ana ya'ni min as-sama, that he will be descending from the sama. Li'anna Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala rafa'ahu ilayhi, as in the Quran, bar rafa'ahu Allah ilayhi. Now this, as we mentioned last week, that this is also another proof that Allah is above the heaven, the seven heavens. بَرْ رَفَعَهُ اللَّهُ إِلَيْهِ. Right? But Allah, He raised him. Allah raised him to him. So this raising part to Allah, it shows what? That Allah is above the heavens. That shows the عُلُوَّةِ اللَّهِ. It shows the highness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, meaning being above everything from his creation. So he mentioned, now the talk, he is dealing with the issue of لَمَّا أَرَادَ الْيَهُودُ قَتُلُهُ, when the Yahud, they wanted to kill Isa alayhi salatu wasalam. I'm sorry?
Can I read the next line?
Which one?
Whatever next line.
Oh, sure, yeah. Get ready. I'll ask you to read anyone I want to. Not anyone you want to. So he mentioned, Hafidhahullah, لَمَّا أَرَادَ الْيَهُودُ قَتْلُهُ, when the Yahud, they wanted to kill Isa alayhi salatu wasalam. And as we mentioned, And as Allah Jalla wa'ala mentioned in the Quran, that the Yahud, any time a prophet was sent to them, kullama ja'ahum, bima la tahwa anfusahum, fariqun kadhabu wa fariqun yaqtulun, that either if they don't deny them and belie them, declare them to be liars, they will kill them. Any prophet that come, bima la tahwa anfusuhum, that is not in line with their agenda, that is not saying what they want to hear, fariqun, a group, they will kill them, they will belie them, and another group, they will kill them. So this is that which that was from the ways of the Yahud. Right. Kullama arsala rusulan tatra, that any time that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent a messenger, they will try to kill him. If he's not speaking on that which is in term with their ways, they will want to take you out. So Isa alayhi salatu wa salam, that the Yahud, when they wanted to kill him, waja'u ilayhi, and they came to him, liyubashiru qatlahu, and they wanted to, when they come to give him the, yani announce him the news of they're going to kill him, and likewise that they're going to crucify him, وَدَخَلُوا عَلَيْهِ, and they will, they enter into him, meaning in the place that he was. At that moment, رَفَعَهُ اللَّهُ مِنْ بَيْنِ أَيْدِيهِمْ وَهُمْ لَا يَشْعُرُونَ, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala right away under their nose raised Isa alayhi salatu wa salam, وَهُمْ لَا يَشْعُرُونَ, and they did not know. Now this was in the same line as the help of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He is in a room. People, they are coming in a room. There is not windows that you can run away from, escape and run, right? The military expedition, they are coming. Well trained to take you down, they are coming. In the room. You by yourself. You don't have no weapon. You don't have nobody. It's you. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala aided him in a way that his enemies could not think about. Or maybe in a way himself could not think that this is how Allah was going to save them. When Musa alayhi salatu wasalam was in front of the water, ماذا قالوا أصحاب موسى, what did the people of Musa say? Inna lamudrakun, we are destroyed, we are done. But Musa alayhi salam didn't have no doubt that the Nasr, An-Nasr min Allah, as he told them before, wasta'inu billahi wasbiru innal aqibatu lil muttaqin, that hold on firm upon patience. Wasta'inu billahi wasbiru, hold on and be patient for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَاسْتَعِينُوا بِاللَّهِ وَاصْبِرُوا, seek assistance and aid from Allah and be patient, be diligent in being patient, for indeed the outcome, it is only for the believers. وَالْأَرْضُ يُورِثُهَا مَنْ يَشَاءُ مِنْ عِبَادِي, that the earth, it will be given authority only for those whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has aided, meaning from those that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wish. So likewise, the same issue with the Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam. Lama ulqi finnar, when he was thrown, when lama ulqiya finnar, when he was thrown in the fire. But there he was in the fire. But this is because of what? Having a total reliance of Allah. And another important issue, as Sheikh Abdul Razak Al-Badr Hafizahullah mentioned, وَالثِّقَةُ مَعَ اللَّهِ, وَالثِّقَةُ مَعَ اللَّهِ, having your trust in Allah. And also, barakallahu feekum, relying upon Allah and having trust in Allah. Because to trust, to rely upon Allah is one thing, but to have trust in Allah is another thing. So you look at these two issues, how Allah saved Isa alayhi salam.